Marvellous Marvel.
Your monthly Marvel catch-up on the cinematic universe.
Welcome to the Marvellous Marvel podcast. My name's Sarah.
My name's Rebecca.
And today in this podcast, we're going to be talking about the Iron Man trilogy. So, Rebecca.
Yes?
What is your most favourite Iron Man film out of the three that exist?
Probably the second one. I don't know why,
I found that one quite interesting, I didn't think that the villain was okay, but I wouldn't say it was my favourite Iron Man movie.
Yeah.
It's good, don't get me wrong, but yeah.
Yeah.
So mine would be probably Iron Man 3, even though people say that the villain wasn't good because the villain wasn't really a villain, apparently. But I think that the villain was I thought it was a good villain, but then I realised that the film kind of didn't exist because it was the Mandarin, I think.
Yeah.
In that one. So, I also liked Iron Man 3 because of.
Tony in general.
Tony. Yeah. I liked it because it was the first time that Tony had a fight without a suit because he didn't have a suit to help him. And it proved that Tony was
Iron Man in himself.
He didn't need the suit to be Iron Man, whereas any other superhero like Captain America.
He needs a suit to be Captain America.
Does he need the suit?
You look at Thor.
Thor without his suit is who is this guy?
He's just a Prince of Asgard.
Yes. You could say all of the superheroes need the suits, but Tony in general, because he's not really classed as a superhero as himself, you get me. Everyone else has got their
billionaire playboy.
Landfist, yeah. Everyone else has got their powers given to them, sort of. But Hawkeye
was born with it, I think.
Yeah. Whereas Tony made himself a superhero, the suit made him look like. When he didn't wear the suit, he wasn't Iron Man, it was just Tony Stark.
Mm-hmm.
Iron Man 3 proved that he didn't really need it.
Yes.
So we'll go on to the next one. Do you think they will make Iron Man 4?
Well, given the current events, what we have seen in Avengers Infinity War and also when Endgame comes out, will Iron Man still be around?
I'm thinking that Tony's just going to retire. I don't want Tony to die.
I don't want him to die either, but, I think he'd either die or retire, one of them. And, we've seen on little stuff that, only a couple of the Avengers actually remain.
It's, been rumoured that only two of them may count before he died. But I'm they can't kill off all of them that easily. I'm
no. The main one who needs to die is Captain America. Sam or Bucky can take over Captain America.
Yes.
Because I feel it will be Bucky that takes it over.
Yeah, I have a feeling that they're going to kill off Steve.
Mm-hmm.
But I have a feeling that they're going to kill off Tony because Tony's the one that started it. Mm-hmm. Tony's going to be the one that
He's the original Avenger. Even though Captain America is, but Tony mainly made it.
Yeah, they're probably going to end the one that started it all.
And yeah.
Because I've heard they're going to be bringing the Young Avengers and that in it. Something like that. But will they make Iron Man 4? Will they make Iron Man 4? I'm thinking probably not, because I don't think I'm pretty sure Robert Downey Jr. said that he was done playing Iron Man.
Mm-hmm.
He was getting ready to quit the role or something like that. But they say these things and then they just don't mean it sometimes.
Yeah.
I think his contract is about to run out after Endgame.
Yeah, I think it is. Because I think they said, like, there'll be this many movies and then the contract ends.
I think he did renew it.
Mm.
But,
that's probably for different things.
He's probably going to renew it again if he's in another movie. Who's your favourite character from the Iron Man trilogy?
Probably Rhodes, but the second Rhodes, not the first one.
The one Don Cheadle plays?
Yes.
Yeah. I didn't like the first one. I heard that he was asking for more money than Robert Downey Jr. because he got him to act in it or something like that. And I'm like, oh, you can't really do that. I agree. I like that Rhodes a lot better.
Because Andy's been through all the Marvel movies, so...
It feels like Rhodes. I mean, imagine if Don Cheadle wasn't Rhodes and
I think it'd just be a total different kind of character.
It wouldn't be
the Rhodes. It'd be like just this random person that's...
Yeah. It would have been certainly odd. Because, I don't think he really played a good Rhodes, to be quite fair, anyway.
Yeah.
My favourite character... from the Iron Man trilogy is obviously Tony because he's my fave. It's interesting all the suits he makes.
Yeah.
And all everything he's gone through.
And gets put in pain quite a lot.
Yeah, poor thing. So we've already spoke about this, but what do you think the future of Marvel and or Tony would be?
Well, we both, like me and you both know it's not going to be good.
Yeah.
By what we've seen in trailers and stuff like that. And like what we've seen in Infinity War.
Yeah.
Half the characters are just going to be wiped out as we've seen. And then new ones will come in and I think it'll just go downhill because it's not the original ones that we know and love.
Oh yeah, that is actually true. Gonna be sad.
Except for Bucky, I like. So if he's the new Avenger, I'd like that.
You just want Bucky to become Captain America.
I do. I think, in my opinion, I think he'd be the best Captain America.
Yeah.
And you see in the comics, he becomes Captain America. So if the mix, like, if they're going off the comics, they should make Bucky Captain America. If they make Sam Captain America, I'm gonna be like, nah.
I don't think Sam would want to become Captain America. It's like. Yeah. So, speaking about the future of Marvel, how do you think the events of Infinity War is gonna go on to Endgame? As we were talking about that,
I think, like, I do hope they bring the characters back because, like,
they probably will.
Because I cried so much in that, and if they don't bring any of my favorite characters back, there's gonna be more tears.
Marty is more crying through the full film.
Yes, as we witnessed.
The intro to Captain Marvel was
amazing.
Did
Stan Lee proud.
Did, yeah. It was very, very heartwarming.
Yeah.
I'm just not looking forward to the...
I'm just not looking... Like, if they do make more Marvel movies, I'm not going to look forward to it because you won't have the cameo that you love. Like, you expect to see the cameo, but then... Since Stan Lee's gone, you won't see the iconic cameos.
They might CG it all, but like this is, it's not. I've
heard that Endgame is actually his last cameo. So if they make any more, they're not going to have his cameos anymore.
I mean, they probably like put him as Easter eggs, but it's not going to be the same.
No, they could have like pictures of him. That could be like his Easter egg.
There was an Easter egg in Deadpool 2, I think, of him on a
billboard.
It's like a graffiti of Stanley.
My dad was like, because me and my dad were watching it, and he was like, are we sure Stan Lee's in a cameo in this? I was like, yeah, go back. And he went back and he was like, there it is.
Yeah.
Like, because I instantly saw it.
I didn't get it the first time round when I watched it. I was like, well, where was Stan Lee? And then I watched it again. I was like, oh,
there he is.
What's your favourite Iron Man suit out of all the ones he made?
Probably the first one.
The very first one with the flamethrowers.
Yeah, and because probably most of it because it got stolen, so.
Oh, yeah, that
it shows how much valuable it actually was.
It didn't in Did he bring it back from the desert?
I don't know.
Because I'm pretty sure the one that the villain in Iron Man 1 has, he has something like that suit.
Mm-hmm.
And when he comes out of the cave, that suit just obliterates. And then when that guy's wearing it, it's like indestructible almost. It's probably not the same suit, but if it was, that would be hilarious. My suit is probably the Mark 42 suit. Don't ask me why. I just like that suit. I think it's because of the colour design. Because it's mostly gold, isn't it? I'm pretty mm-hmm. sure. Yeah. And if I remember that suit... No, it's not that suit that comes, like, calls to him, isn't it?
I think so. I'm not quite sure.
Because in Avengers, he has the one that connects with the bracelets around his wrist.
Mm.
I think Mark 42 is the one that he can control outside. What did you think of Captain Marvel?
I really loved it. I think it was pretty, like, amazing in itself.
I
see her, believe her.
Yeah. it was definitely a good film.
Mm-hmm.
I
was impressed a lot, especially with the beginning. It was heartbreaking, but
yes,
it was well needed.
What did you think of young Nick Fury and Coulson, Coulson had only just started the team?
Well, I think it was very, like, different because, like, you never really saw Phil as he was in the beginning.
Yeah.
So this is kind of giving a new light to Phil Coulson and how attached he got to Nick in the first
couple of days, like,
mm-hmm.
they had that bond very strong.
Mm-hmm. Especially since we saw what happened, spoilers, but, like, what we saw happened when they were going somewhere, it's like, they just stopped.
It's a shame that we didn't see much of Phil, though. We only saw him.
We saw a different version of him.
We saw a different Phil. I just wish they didn't kill him off in Avengers. Could have think of the possibilities that we could have had with Phil.
Mm-hmm.
Shall we react to the trailers again from Iron Man 1 to Iron Man 3, 2 months and 8, put my glasses on.
No one's allowed to talk, is that it? You can't talk?
No, you intimidate them.
Good God, you're a woman.
Is it better to be feared or respected? And I say, is it too much to ask for both? I humbly present the Jericho. Peace.
Tony Stark. Now you work for me.
What are you building, Stark?
Your eyes are red. Your tears for your long-lost boss?
Tears of joy. I hate job hunting.
Yeah, vacation's over.
Welcome home, sir.
Put up the scanner, will you? What happened over there?
I had my eyes open.
I want to protect the people I put in harm's way.
A man with a dozen of these can rule all of Asia.
Yeah, I can fly.
Let's see if this dog can hunt.
So the upgrade is complete.
Tell you what, throw a little hot rod red in there.
Damn.
Good luck keeping up.
What's going on here?
Let's face it, this is not the worst thing you've caught me doing.
There's been speculation that I'm parading around as a superhero. I'm just not the hero type, clearly.
Wow.
Yeah. Well, I forgot how good that trailer is.
Mm-hmm.
So going back to that trailer, what would have you seen Iron Man 1?
I have, when we did the movie marathon.
So if you hadn't seen that movie before you saw that trailer, how would you feel?
A bit confused.
I would definitely be confused in a way, sort of.
But the trailer kind of lets a bit more hindsight of everything, he got blew up, he turned into Iron Man, and he makes it look like he's not Iron Man. Like, he rejects that he's Iron Man.
Yeah. The villains.
Annoying.
Sure. In that, yeah.
Villains annoying.
His villain's actually one of his dad's friends, but they captured that villain quite well in that trailer, I think. I mean, if I'd never seen the film, I'd probably be like,
who is all these?
I'd be like, wait, what? There's a lot going on at once.
Yeah, that kind of gives a hindsight of, like, this is the layout that we want to go for, and this is what were basically given to you.
Yeah, it kind of, after watching the movie, you watch the trailer, it's like, the trailer almost, like, it tells you what happens.
Yeah.
But, like, you wouldn't know if you didn't know, if you get me. Now we're going to listen to Iron Man 2's trailer.
Oh, it's good to be back.
The notary's here.
Front and center.
I'm sorry, he's very eccentric.
I want one.
No.
If you can make God bleed, people will cease to believe in him. And there will be blood in the water. And the sharks will come. All I have to do is sit here and watch as the world will consume you.
Our priority is to get the Iron Man weapon turned over to the United States of America.
I am Iron Man. The suit and I are one.
Contrary to popular belief, I know exactly what I'm doing.
What?
What I saw you do to Tony Stark on that track?
Wow.
You need my resources.
I want to make Iron Man look like an antique.
This whole lone gunslinger act's unnecessary. You don't have to do this alone.
I hope you're ready.
Come on!
Mr. Stark displays textbook narcissism. Agreed?
Get up!
What did you think of that trailer?
I like this one a bit more. It's got a new road, it's got that iconic song Iron Man by Black Sabbath as well.
Yes, yeah.
So
it's used a lot, that, but then again,
it's Iron Man.
So it's only good for them to use it. Yes, there's a lot more character depth in Iron Man now after the events of Iron Man 1.
He's got more enemies.
Yeah, the wanting the Iron Man suit to be took off him, but then he says, like, the Iron Man suit and me year one.
And then we meet Nick Fury for the first time.
Yeah, we meet Black Widow as well. Yes. The villain is
a lot more.
It's kind of like two villains in a way, because there's the Whiplash, and then there's that other guy. Oh god, it's been that long I've watched the movie, I can't remember his name, but he's the one who adds all of the guns onto Rhodey's thing because he gets Rhodey to take one of Tony's suits and he weaponizes it to show the world that his suits can be weaponized or something like that. So yeah.
Are we ready for the third one now?
Now let's listen to the Iron Man 3
trailer. The last trailer.
The last trailer, yeah.
Got a lot of apologies to make.
Nothing's been the same since New York. You experience things, and then they're over. I can't sleep. And when I do, I have nightmares. Honestly, there's 100 people who want to kill me. I hope I can protect the one thing I can't live without.
Ladies, children, sheep. Some people call me a terrorist. I consider myself a teacher. Lesson number one. Heroes, there is no such thing.
So, what did you think?
That one was top notch. Sadly, it didn't have the iconic song.
No, it didn't.
So it shows that he's changed quite a bit.
Oh yeah, he changes. He changes quite a bit in this movie. The thing I enjoyed the most about this movie is they shown us that stuff can affect superheroes, like normal people, because like after when this takes place, it's after Avengers, and it's after he's been up in the wormhole, mm-hmm. and he gets a load of like anxiety and mm-hmm. that. So it shows that in the movie, which I quite like, because it shows that
he's only human.
He's human. Anything can affect him. He's not perfect.
He can feel.
He has emotions, yeah. They show the villain quite well in the trailer, but like in the movie, the villain's a bit as well. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. They didn't show the villains actually. They're like the fire people, the people who got the fire. You know, in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., how the first episodes you see that you meet these people who have these powers that have like who explode.
Yeah,
it's the same stuff mm-hmm. from Iron Man 3, so it's a nice link to the TV shows as well. That one's my favorite movie.
Yes,
I can't not hate Iron Man 3 as much as people like to hate on it.
Mm-hmm.
It's one of my favorites and it always will be. So while we're here watching trailers, and it's on the thingy of Marvel, do you want to react to the recent Endgame trailer?
Could
so that. Yeah, I mean, it's really... I've seen the trailer, and it's definitely something, right? So let's listen to the Avengers Endgame trailer while we're on the topic of trailers.
God, seems like 1,000 years ago. I fought my way out of that cave. Became Iron Man. Realized I loved you. I know I said no more surprises, but I was really hoping to pull off one last one.
The world has changed. None of us can go back.
all we can do is our best. And sometimes the best that we can do is to start over.
I saw all these people die.
I keep telling everybody they should move on. Some do. But not us.
Even if there's a small chance, we owe this to everyone who's not in this room to try.
We will. Whatever it takes. Whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes.
I like this one.
So yeah, that was the Avengers Endgame trailer. And what do you feel about that?
I love that one.
Yeah.
Because they're all together. Like, when you're watching it like we did, you see the logo fade in. You don't see it, like, disappear. So it's like, yes.
Yeah. It's like a message of the Avengers are gonna
restore the balance of time,
pull the pieces back together and restore it again somehow. I still don't understand how they're gonna do it.
No,
it's gonna be interesting.
Definitely.
I also like how the recycled old movie footage instead of actually like putting loads of the movie into it.
Yeah.
So that it. Good. So when we go see the movie, we're gonna get a surprise. Like I have no idea what's gonna happen.
Nah, neither do I.
So everyone's gonna go into the movie blind. Even if like, if it gets spoiled, then yeah. If you don't get it spoiled and you go into the movie and you watch it without knowing anything, I think it's gonna be a very hard hitting movie.
Yeah.
With all of the possibilities that could happen with people dying. I've heard Steve could go back in time, steal Peggy.
Mm-hmm.
But the point is, like, I kind of like the idea of time travel, but that
how
means...
How's it going to affect it all?
Yeah, that means every other movie that's came out is just irrelevant now.
Mm-hmm.
But I heard that Kevin Feige said that all of them movies are post-Infinity War, something like that. He's called them post-Infinity War, something like that.
Yeah, like, you'd say T'Challa wouldn't become...
Yeah, he wouldn't become king because the events of Bucky killing... Wait, not Bucky. It wasn't even Bucky, wasn't it?
No, it was... Other ones?
It was... Oh, who was it? It was somewhere. I can't remember exactly. Wasn't that Zemo?
I think it was Zemo.
Yeah. So, yeah, the events of... King T'Chaka dying, then that probably might not happen, and then
T'Challa
might not get the king's rule
it's time for his father to go. So
it's like Doctor Strange might not have had the car crash,
so he wouldn't become
Doctor Strange. That's what I'm worried about.
Cause well, it'll still be Doctor Strange, but
yeah,
it won't be Doctor Strange.
Yeah. So there's a lot of stuff that could
affect the timeline
if they go back in time. It's the risk
they're going to turn into X-Men.
Yeah, it basically is. The whole X-Men's timeline is messed up. So it's going to be interesting for definite.
But what we've noticed with, again, Captain America, no spoilers, but might be a little bit, with when the cat goes... throws up the Tesseract. It's like, that's probably where they get...
Spoiler.
The stone from. Well, I said spoiler, didn't I? That's probably where they get the stone from.
Yeah, maybe. Think of all the people, like, you know, in Infinity War, how Thanos killed some of the people and said, like, stab them. It's going to be interesting if they're going to come back. Like, Gamora and Loki.
I don't think Gamora would come back, and I don't think Loki's going to come back.
For once, they actually kill Loki and they don't bring him back. That's going to be...
That's going to be heartbreaking for me, because I love Loki.
How many times has Loki died? Thor 1.
Thor 2.
Yeah, he died in Thor 2. He didn't die in the third Thor.
To be honest, he should have stayed on where he was going to stop.
That's an achievement for Loki. And then, so he's died 3 times so far. And then,
to be honest, he should have just stayed on... Imagine if they go back time, and it's when he's on Thingy, and Thor tells him to stop on there.
Stop on Sakaar.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He literally tells him to stop on Sakaar.
Yeah. He should, because in the movie, doesn't Loki say that he'd be better off staying in Sakaar? Mm-hmm. And then I'm like,
you should have.
At the beginning of Infinity War, you're like, no, Loki, you should have stayed on Sakaar.
Yeah, but you never think, you might think.
Yeah.
They might, when they go back in time, Thor might say, Loki, stop here, because he will know what happens.
Yeah.
So, like, just stop here, do not come with me.
What do you think the fate of Korg is? Yeah,
I don't know. I know he's a pile of rocks, so he's probably like...
He's probably like disintegrating into loads of like...
Tiny little pebbles.
I'm pretty sure he'll be with Valkyrie, because Valkyrie has been advertised being the movie, and only half the Asgardians got killed, so the other half might have escaped with Korg and...
Well, to be honest, he's already balanced the universe with the Asgardians.
I know. So hang on a minute, actually. He wipes out half of existence. Does that mean after he's killed that half of existence, does the other half die?
Probably.
Because he went out in a massive massacre, killing half the population of every universe, and then he just goes and snaps his fingers and wipes out half the... Does that mean it only affects that planet, or does it affect like every...
I think it'll affect all planets, because might be, because like he said, he wants to balance the universe. The universe is basically all the planets.
Well, he's already balanced a few. He balanced Gamora's planet, and now he snapped his fingers, so that's the other half gone, probably.
You think about Asgard.
Asgard, yeah.
The Asgardian people, they're chopped in half.
That means he hasn't balanced it. He's just balanced it and then balanced it again.
Yeah.
So technically...
To be honest, he's only doing this because all his planet died. It's like, what the hell?
I can sort of sympathise with Thanos, because he watched his planet die and he just wants to do right. But he's going about it in the wrong way.
Yeah. Like, he shouldn't snap half out of the universe.
Why can't he snap his fingers and create more stuff?
Why doesn't he just reverse time to where his planet's alive?
Yes. And then didn't they kick him off his planet because he thought he went mad. And that's why he got the Mad Titan. It's a whole load of confusing business.
Yeah.
Infinity War. It's like everything seemed to happen all at once and you never got a break.
That's why I cried for all the movie.
It's like something funny happened.
The laugh. You laugh.
And then something sad happens. Instant
cry again.
And you would be like crying again. I think I remember things like that.
It happened to me. It was Vision's bit.
Vision's bit.
Where we got brought back and I was like, oh! And then died again. I was like, oh! It was like a happy, oh! And then, oh! Just cry.
Oh, I remember the ending. I was okay until after he snapped his fingers and Bucky was the first one faded.
I was like, no!
Why couldn't it have been a character I'm not as...
I cried. Like, the saddest part for me is I had a T'Challa bear when T'Challa faded.
Yeah. I wish the fade is one of the characters that aren't really like...
The Avengers.
Yeah. Someone
fade one of the Wakandans.
Yeah. Why didn't they not start fading the Wakandans first? Then going to it easier instead of just totally like going to Bucky and like wiping Bucky out straight away. I'm like, Bucky dying right in front of Steve again.
Well, technically he didn't die the first time.
Technically, but Steve thought he did.
Hmm.
Oh, talking about that, you know how Steve, Bucky falls off the train?
Mm-hmm.
There's a similar moment to that where Tony in Iron Man 3 actually, Pepper falls and Tony thinks she's dead. Mm-hmm. So technically, you could say they experience similar things mm-hmm. with their...
They're basically the same.
Friends, with the friends, or people who...
They care about.
And so yeah, I think they both experience similar. So technically, because like I know there's a big massive feud between Captain America mm-hmm. and Iron Man at the moment after the fates of Civil War. So basically, you could stop that and tell the people who don't like the idea of Captain America and Iron Man being buddies. Yeah, they both experience similar things. They're both kind of strong in a way.
They're both wrong in their own ways.
Yes, I agree. As much as I'm mostly Team Iron Man, I agree that Tony...
I'm Team Bucky.
You're just Team Bucky. You're none of the teams. You just chose Bucky's side.
Yeah.
Yeah. I agree that Steve went about it wrong. Tony went about it wrong. They all went about it wrong.
And ended up just making people die. They ended up making people die.
Yes. I mean, they trashed a massive airport just for a big, fight. Massive cat fight.
And it was really a cat fight because the Charlie came in.
Yeah.
I love how Bucky reaction though, just sees this like claw coming towards him. He's like, oh my god, no.
I just like the fact that, like, it just brought all the superheroes together. Like, it was the first time we saw
Ant-Man.
Did we not see Ant-Man in Ant-Man before that?
We saw the old Ant-Man, we didn't see the new Ant-Man.
Maybe, yeah. So, we saw Ant-Man, we saw
T'Challa,
we saw Black Panther. The Winter Soldier got brought in as a quote-unquote good guy,
mm-hmm.
sort of. Spider-Man. We got introduced to Spider-Man.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that's the end of this podcast. And yeah.
Hope you enjoyed.
Hope you enjoyed listening. Bye.
Bye.